Insurance. Good afternoon, everyone. How are you all? I hope you all are doing good and safe, and your parents too, safe and good. Okay, let's welcome to moral class. I hope you all are following all the moral values what we have learned in previous classes. Today our class is the real gift. Today our topic is the real gift. I hope you all like to get gifts, right? Also you have to give gifts to others also. That's in not the form of solid forms, not only in the form of solid forms, that means things or pen, pencil, like not like that. You can help others, that also a real gift. That is the real gift. Okay, whenever us need something, you can help them. The help is the best gift in the world. Okay, let's move into our class today. First, let's see one story. The people of Azipur village were very poor. They would hardly have food for many weeks. This left them with very little energy to do any work. The king Parvat Singh did not care for the villagers. One day, three merchants came to the village. They left sorry for the starving villagers. So the next day, the first merchant went back to the village. He took a carriage full of grains and pulses and distributed them in the village. Then the merchant went back to town. He boasted about his act to the townspeople. The following day, the second merchant went to the village. He gave the villagers a huge supply of fruits and vegetables. Then, just like the first merchant, he told the townspeople about his wonderful deed. The two merchants then called the third merchant and said, "We have helped the villagers in every way we could. We have given them grains, pulses, fruits, vegetables. There is nothing more to be done for them." The third merchant said, "That is very kind of you. However, I still want to go to Azipur and see what more can be done." And he set off for the village. The two merchants followed him there. Upon reaching the village, the third merchant unloaded his carriage. He had brought farming tools and sacks of seeds. He had found a way to help the villagers to earn money for their families. They would not need anybody's help anymore. Then he returned to the town and did not say a word about it to anyone. The two merchants realized that the third merchant had truly helped the villagers, while they had only given things so that they could hear people praising them. Okay, I hope you all understood the story, right? The three merchants really helped the people, but two merchants were helped only temporarily, right? For short time help they have done, but the third merchant was really helped them for their entire life. He didn't see that problem temporarily. He just solved their problems permanently, right? So whenever you are trying to help others, you just think whether your help will fulfill their needs for temporarily or permanently. If your help is for permanently will help for them, means that will be very good. But sometimes the temporarily we are doing help, that also important, right? The first two merchants did also good only because the villagers were very weak at that time, right? They gave enough food for them, so they had strength in their body to do any work. After the third merchant gave enough tools and sacks of seeds, right, so they can cultivate and they can do farming and they can earn enough money, enough food for them, right? So whenever you are doing help to others, you just think whether your help is essential for them, it will help others temporarily or permanently. You just think and do it, because all the things, all the helps we are doing is very valuable, right? So help others whenever anyone is in need. Don't avoid them, don't show long face to them. You just be smile. You, whatever help you are doing, just do with a smile, then that help will be taken for them grandly. So you just do help others, make others be happy, then the happiness will come within you and you also feel more better, more happy than others. You itself think when you are helping to some others, that time own happiness will come into your mind, right? That is very great. We could not purchase that with the money. So help others, you'll get a nice feel, a nice happiness in it within you. So just help and maintain the social responsibility. The three merchants were did social responsibility, right? They did their job, they helped the villagers. That is social responsibility. We also have to do help others, and that help, we should have that social responsibility with us. Okay kids, you all understood today's moral values, right? Helpfulness and social responsibility. And the third merchant did is remind us one proverb, right? Give a man a fish and you feed him for a day. That means give a man a fish means you are giving a fish to eat that man, he is hungry, okay? But when you are teaching that man to get a fish, that you are training them, training the person to get the fish, that will help him permanently, right? Whenever he is hungry, he can get the fish. So when you are helping others, you just think whether the help will help them permanently or temporarily, okay? Okay, can you see this picture? The girl missed her school bus. Sometimes if you miss your school bus, what you will do? Will you blame your parents? You will keep grumbling the whole day? No, right? You should decide to set a alarm every day, then you can go early, right? So this boy's football shoes are very dirty. What he has to do? He has to clean the shoes by himself, right? Instead of waiting for someone to help, otherwise wearing the dirty shoes, he has to clean the shoes, right? This two situations are given in our moral book, the page number 23, skills for life, okay? So the first answer is decide to set alarm every day. The second answer is clean the shoes yourself. You just read that, you'll know. Just take the answer, okay? Okay, let me read today's notes, okay? First, choose the correct answer. One, the first merchant took a carriage full of A, grains and pulses, B, fruits, C, water. The answer is grains and pulses. By giving them farming tools and seeds, the third merchant, option A, made life difficult for the villagers. Option B, helped the villagers to earn money for their families. C, made the villagers lazy. The answer is helped the villagers to earn money for their families. And answer the following first question. Why did the merchants went to help the people of Azipur? Answer. The people of Azipur village were very poor and they hardly had their food for many weeks. So the merchants wanted to help them. 2. How was the help given by the third merchant more beneficial? Answer. The help given by the third merchant was way more beneficial because he gave farming tools and seeds to the villagers so that they could overcome their poverty permanently. Third question. What do you think about the first and the second merchants? Answer. The first and the second merchants helped the people temporarily by giving them enough food. Okay, my dears, I hope you all understood about today's class and follow today's moral values. What are they? Social responsibility and helpfulness. Follow this whenever you can. You just help others, those who are in need, those who are need something. You just give them, you just help them with a cute smile, okay? Whenever you need to do your responsibility for the social society, you just do your help, okay? Be smile, be active, always kind to others. Thank you, my dears. We'll meet in the next class. Bye-bye.